Let's take a short look at the reorder policy fixed order quantity and how that works. If I'm entering an item card in Business Central, on the planning tab, I could suggest fixed reorder quantity like this. And if I have fixed reorder quantity, I could add here a reorder point, reorder quantity, and I have my safety stock. So for instance here, I could set a reorder point being 50, a reorder quantity being 100, and the safety stock being 5, as an example. Let's see how it works if we draw it. So if the bolded line is the inventory level, starting with whatever inventory quantity, and there's a withdraw on the inventory, meaning every time there's a demand, we pick a little from the inventory, we have a withdraw, and when we trigger the reorder point, it will create a forward planned order. Production order if it's a production item, of course, purchase order if it's a purchase items, etc. And after the lead time, the quantity will get to stock and fulfill my inventory with my order quantity, so the reorder quantity. And that's the same quantity every time when I used fixed reorder quantity. And likewise again, when it withdraw, there's a trigger, it calculate forward. And in the last example, it triggers and it normally would calculate forward, but within that period, it actually triggers on the safety stock and therefore it calculates backward and make an order start earlier. So it will be a backward planned order with the order quantity and therefore it hits the inventory earlier, of course. So this is what we normally do with simple items or item with expectable withdrawal and continuous withdrawal.